Today's title is called Slope of a Line. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to figure out the slope of a line two different ways. First, what I need in your notes is what the definition of slope is. So slope is the rate of change that determines the direction of a line and how steep it is. So sometimes we have a positive slope, or sometimes we have a negative slope. But make sure this is in your notes. Now, there are different ways of thinking of slope. One way to think of slope is the vertical change over the horizontal change. So remember, vertical change, we're going up. Let's change color, sorry. Vertical change, that means we're either going to go up or we're going to go down. And then horizontal change is either we're going to go right or we can also go left. So that's one way of thinking of slope. Another way of thinking of slope is the change in y over the change of x. And what do you mean by the change of y over change of x? If we take a look at this point and then another point up here, we're starting at, let's see, 0, 1, and we're ending at, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4, 7. So change of y. How does my y value change? I started at 1, now I'm at 7. Then, my change of x. I started at 0, and now I'm at 4. So we're looking at how our points are going to change on our line. One way you might have heard of is something called rise over run. What do we mean by rise over run? Well, think of it this way. When we rise, our y value is changing. I was going up, I'm rising, then I'm running, which means my x value is going to change, so I move on the x-axis. So another way of thinking about it is rise over run. The big thing, one thing I really want you to take away of, if we're slope, if you ever see the variable m, we are referring to slope. I don't know why they choose m as slope, but m always represents slope. So we're now going to find the slope of this line. So first, we're going to look for how far we're going to rise. So I rose a positive 3. How did I figure out positive 3? Well, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. We're all dealing with positive numbers. So I'm trying to connect this point with that point. So I just count how many I rose by. 1, 2, 3. That's where my positive 3 came from. So there's my positive 3. That's how much I rose, or my rise. Then, how many did I run by? So let's figure that out. So I take a look. I'm trying to connect this point to this point, so I went up a positive 3, so this right here was my stopping point. Now I gotta move how many? Let's count. 1, 2, so that's where they got the 2 from. Now, how'd they get the positive? Take a look where we are on the x-axis. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They're all positive numbers, so that's how I got a positive 2. So we put a positive 2, and since they're both positives, we can simplify this. So our slope is 3 over 2. Now in this case, we went in the positive direction. We went up and then we went to the right. Another way of connecting those same points is we can go down and to the left. So we're still finding slope, so see what happens. So we're going to go down a negative 6. Now how did I figure out negative 6? In this case, I'm trying to connect this point to that point. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's where they got the 6 from. But how did I get this negative? Take a look on how we're changing on the y-axis. We're going down. So I started with 1 here, 0. Now I'm at negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. I'm moving in a negative direction. That's where I got my negative 6 from. So in this case, I have a negative 6. Now I'm still connecting the other point. Then I moved a negative 4. Now how in the world did I get negative 4? So before we count it, so the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so that's where my negative 6 came from. This was my stopping point. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we know how they got the 4, how they get the negative. We'll take a look how we're changing on the x-axis. We're moving to the left, which is a negative direction. We start at 1, we got 0, now we have negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. Once again, we're dealing in a negative direction. That's how I get a negative 4. So I get my negative 4, and you're telling me, well, Ms. Martin, those are two different slopes. Why do we get two different values? Well, don't forget, we can simplify this. Double negatives will become positive. 6 and 4 have a common factor. we can divide them both by 2. And if you notice, we still get 3/2 as our answer. So be aware, when you're looking at the vertical change or the horizontal change, or if you're looking at it as the change in y, the change in x, or as something as easy as rise over run, different ways of looking at it. We can go in the positive direction first, or you can also go in the negative direction, but you will still get the same exact answer. Why? All these points are on the same line. Since they're on the same line, they have the same slope. So the directions tell us we have to find the slope. So slope, which is also equal to m. So slope. I like to think of it as rise over run. So first off, you always need 2 points. Always need 2 points. Otherwise, you have no idea which direction you're going. So I'm going to choose this point, and I'm going to choose that point. So let's see how they're connected. How can I get them together? So if I want to get from this point all the way to that point, how do I do it? So looking at it, I need to rise. So I'm going to go up. Let's see how many spaces. It looks like 1. Now which direction am I going? I'm going in a positive direction. That's why it's going to be a +1. Now I have my rise, so I have my m is equal to 1. Now I'm going to need my run. So how many spaces am I going to move? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I move 4, and once again I notice I'm moving in this direction. It's a positive direction, so it should be a +4. Oh, I forgot my plus from 1, sorry. +1, +4. And since they're both positives, this will equal 1/4. 1/4 is going to be my answer. So on your own, I want you to find the slope of the line below. If you're solving on your own, you should have gotten 3 as your answer. Whether you're going in the positive direction or in the negative direction, you'll still get the same exact answer, which is 3. Now, on your own, find the slope of this line. If you're solving on your own, you should have gotten -2/3. Once again, doesn't matter which direction you go in, you will always get the same exact slope. Why? All these values, all these points are on the same exact line. Now go and write this graph in your notes. Now, every time we found the slope, we've always had our 2 points and our line, and we're able to figure out. Now, let's say we don't have this graph, but we only have 2 points. How can we figure this out? Well, if you notice, there's a pattern forming. Of course, we always need 2 points. So this is point 1, x1, y1, point 2, x2, y2. Now, there's actually a formula to help you figure this out. Because if you notice, when we're running, our x values change. So our x2 minus our x1, because we're trying to figure out the difference between them. Then when we're rising, our y changes, which is y2 minus y1. So since we know it's always rise over run, if you don't have a graph, you can actually take these points and you can plug them into this formula. So everything, it's called the slope formula, everything on this slide I want in your notes. So it's asking us to use a slope formula to find the slope between these given points. Now, we have no graph, so instead of taking the time to graph it and trying to figure out what the slope is, we're going to use our slope formula and these 2 points to figure out how to solve it. So go ahead and put this, both of these, in your notes. So I know what the slope formula is. It is that m is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Now, for this to work, you have to assign values. So I'm going to make this my x1, oh, and I make that a little better. My x1, y1, and I'll make this one my x2, y2. Basically, I'm saying this is point 1 and this is point 2. That's all I'm doing. So now let's plug in these values. What's my y2 value? It's a 9. What's my y1 value? So I use my 9, y1 is a 5, so I subtract 5. Then I need to figure out my x2 value. My x2 value is 6. What's my x1 value? It's 2. We're subtracting them. So all now I do is simplify. What is 9 minus 5? It is 4. What is 6 minus 2? It is also 4. Now, can I leave it as 4? 4. No, you cannot. Why not? We can simplify these. 4 cancels out into 4. 1 over 1. So what's my slope? My slope actually ends up just being 1. Now, on your own, go and try to do number 2. Now, this one's a little bit trickier. We were subtracting a negative number, so that's why these became positives. You had to make sure to simplify, but you should have gotten negative 3/2. Now, it doesn't matter which is 0.1 or which is 0.2, as long as you label it, because either way, you'll get the same exact answer, negative 3/2. So on your own, once again, go ahead and try to solve this using the slope formula. How do you find the slope between these two points? If you're solving on your own, you should have gotten negative 1/3 as your answer. Make sure you label 0.1 and 0.2 and plug in those values. So now go write down everything on the board, and I want you to set it up as is. I want you the points on one side, graph in the middle, points on the other side. On your own, go ahead and try to solve what the slope is for these two points and what the slope is for these two points. Now, if you've been solving, you would have noticed, hey, I got m is equal to 0. How does that work? What 0 means, if you notice, it's going to be for all horizontal lines, it's going to have a slope 0. So look at our horizontal line. You should have noticed, hey, I got a 4 and a 4. My y is the same. Whoops, I can spell same. Is the same. So if you ever have a horizontal line, it's always going to have a slope of 0. So make sure you have that in your notes. Now on the second point, you were like, wait a second, I have 6/0. I can't divide that. So what does that mean? That means it's undefined. So what I also want you to notice is every vertical line has an undefined slope. So this right here is our undefined slope. Whenever it's a vertical line, what's crossing the x-axis. Why is it undefined? We don't know what it is because you can't divide 0 into 6. So it's considered undefined. Make sure everything on the board is in your notes. Another way of thinking about them, they're called zero slope for horizontal or no slope for vertical. Since it's undefined, it technically has no slope. So now I'd like a 2-sentence summary of what we learned today. We learned about the change of y over the change of x. Another way of saying it is rise over run. We also learned about zero slope, no slope, horizontal lines, vertical lines, and the slope formula. 2-sentence summary.